today.
Had an awesome church service, awesome Christmas program, had one baptized, one saved. Children got to sing. All in all, I'd say it was an awesome day at church today.
We had 27 children in children's church today, and it was awesome.
Amen. Lord, I'm just tired. I'm ready to go to bed.
Love you.
Brian.
Is that you, Lord?
Yes, it's me. I have great news for you, Brian. I want you to prepare your house. This very night, I will visit you and your family for Christmas dinner.
You choose me to come spend your Christmas with, Lord?
Yes, all I ask is that you prepare your house.
Christmas time was approaching. Snow was starting to fall. Shoppers choosing their presents. People filling the mall. Children waiting for Santa with excitement and glee. Little boy tugged my sweater, looked up and asked me, "Where's the line to see Jesus? Is he here at the store? If Christmas time is his birthday, then why do we sing more?" I stood in amazement at this message profound. I looked down to thank him. He was nowhere around. Little boy at the mall might as well have had wings as the tears filled my eyes.
Jesus, he was born.
be prepared, and you was really prepared, and everything looks good, everything looks great.
I hope it's good enough. Our Savior deserves the best.
Yeah, I believe it's perfect. If we can just get these kids today. There he is.
Hello, can I help you?
Hi, my name is Matt. Now I'm down on my circumstances. I've lost everything I got. I was looking for a warm meal and a warm place to stay.
Need somewhere to sleep, hon. You're homeless. Brother, if it was any other night, I could probably help you. But as you see, my family and I are ready for a supporting guest. So I don't think I'd be able to help you tonight. I'll tell you what I will do, though. I'll give you $50 and you can go down to the hotel and get you a room.
Thank you.
No, some old hobo. You smell him?
Yeah.
Wake himself since he had a bath today. I gave him $50, told him to go down the road.
Can I help you?
Yes, sir. I've been driving around. My name is Precious, and I'm a prostitute, and I've made a lot of bad decisions in my life. I've been just looking for a friend, someone to talk to, somebody who cares. Do you have time for me? I don't need money. I just need some time, some friendship.
Well, hon, my wife's a pretty good woman to talk to, but this is a bad night. We're expecting an important person for dinner. And I just can't open my house up for somebody tonight. I tell you what, if you'll come by tomorrow night, we'll try to show you a little affection, a little time, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
God bless you. Have a Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Is that you?
Prostitute. There's no way in the world we can have a prostitute here when Jesus is coming. What would she do? What would she say? There's no way.
Can I? Sam.
Yes.
Somebody locked me out of my own house.
Hot.
What in the world has happened to you?
How you doing, sir? My name is Dennis, and then I heard that you could possibly help me out. I'm down on my luck and just need somebody. I'm sorry.
Man, you done pulled you one for Christmas, ain't you? Brother, I'm just gonna tell you the truth, man. I don't give alcoholics money. I tell you what, I can say a quick prayer for you and just wish you the best, but until you get off that booze and do something with your life, you ain't gonna never make nothing, okay? Jesus, help him in your name. Amen.
Thank you, sir.
Sober up, man. Sober up.
Lord, mercy at all nights.
Was that him?
No. Oh, he was tanked up, boy. I'm surprised he didn't smell his alcohol over here. Boy, he was a sot.
What do we have here? A little red-headed stepchild.
Hello, sir. How are you?
Hello.
I'm Troy. This is my wife, Marlena. This is my son, Lucas. I was going to stop by and see if you might have some food to spare. It's Christmas come around. We don't have enough money for food. And, the kids is not getting nothing for Christmas. We barely can make it with our house payment.
Brother. Tell you what I'll do. I'll bring it before the church this coming Sunday. I know it's Christmas, and I know that it looks like we've got plenty, but we're actually expecting somebody. And if we fed y'all your big bunch, then we would be lacking for persons coming. So I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll bring it before the church Sunday, and if they agree, I'll try to help you out, okay?
All right.
I know where you live over there, and I'll come try to help you out, okay?
Okay, thank you.
I wish you the best for Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Was that him?
No. That little family down the street there that everybody talks about. We can't help them. Can't help us. Can't help nobody want to help themselves. Gotta be.
What do we have here?
My name's Glenn. You're the preacher that was at the jailhouse the other day?
Yeah, that's me.
Sir, I'm an addict and I'm down on my luck. That's my dope. Oh, I heard you praying about being empty on this side. Could you help me, sir? Could you help me out?
Son, I'm going to tell you what's wrong with you.
I need your help.
I was there before. You got a void in you. That you're trying to fill with them drugs and them alcohol and all them things in the world that only Christ can fulfill.
Yeah.
And I'd love to help you tonight. Any other night I'd help you.
Tonight.
But as you see, I'm expecting company for Christmas.
Yes.
So the only way you're going to get that joy is you got to seek it through the Lord.
Can you help me?
I tell you what, if you'll come back tomorrow, then maybe I can talk to you, okay?
Okay.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
No, I give up. Here we have, he told me to be prepared. I prepared a good meal. Gave me the best seat in the house, place that I usually sit. And here he don't show up. Maybe I was wrong. Maybe I just didn't hear Jesus.
Back to that same big old slit bottom rocker in front of the fireplace.
And she took out a big old Bible and sat down in front of him and looked up and asked, "Do you understand John 3:16? He said, "No, ma'am, I don't. The first time I ever heard it was last night when the policeman told me to use it." She opened the Bible, John 3:16, and she began to explain to him about Jesus. Right there in front of that big old fireplace, he gave his heart and life to Jesus. He sat there and thought, John 3:16, I don't understand it, but it sure makes a lost boy feel sad. You know, I have to confess, I don't understand it either, how God would be willing to send his son to die for me, and how Jesus would agree to do such a thing. I don't understand it either, but it sure does make life worth living.
Well, I guess I missed the boat on this one, Ron. I'm sorry to prepare this big meal before I'm stuffed. That strawberry pie was awesome. I tell you what, I'm wore out, tired. I just can't believe this is happening tonight, so I'm just ready to go there. Are you?
Yes.
Brian.
Lord, is that you? You told me you was going to come tonight and visit me and have dinner with me. Yet, you never just show up. You never come. I prepared just like you said. You told me to be prepared. And I prepared everything, but you never showed up.
Brian, remember the homeless man. He was desperate and in need and a place to stay. He prayed and I led him to you. Remember the prostitute. Her bad choices had put her in bad places, so she prayed to me for friendship and I led her to you. You sent her away. Remember the alcoholic, Brian. Prayed for help. I sent him to you for you to help. And the family. In need of food, Brian. You had plenty. And the drug addict. Who prayed to me in desperation to be freed from his addiction. So I sent him to you, for I freed you from addiction. Brian, my word is clear, and it says, what you do to the least of them is what you do to me.
Christmas flower.
I shepherds, for the bright shining star. Oh, tell about the wise men who traveled from afar. It's about the cross. It's about my sin. It's about how Jesus came to be born once so that we can be born again. It's about the song.
Just real quick, I want to read a little scripture real quick. I'm not going to try to be long. It goes with our play today. It goes with our mission statement. And my Christmas wish for this church is, and our New Year's thing, is that every one of us get a heart for these needs in this community, in this area, in general. But most of all, that we'd all just get a heart for Jesus, and realize what we do to the least of them is what we do to Him. Verse 31 of Matthew chapter 25 says, "When the Son of Man shall come in His glory, and all the holy angels with Him, then shall He sit upon the throne of His glory. And before Him shall be gathered all nations, and He shall separate them one from another, as the shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. And He shall set the sheep on His right hand, but the goats on His left hand. Then shall the king say unto them on His right hand, Come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me meat." I want you to listen to this. "I was thirsty, you gave me drink. I was a stranger, you took me in." Next verse. "Naked and you clothed me.
I was sick and you visited me. I was in prison, you came unto me. Then shall the righteous answer him, saying, Lord, when shall we thee and hungered and fed thee, or thirsty and gave thee drink? When saw we thee a stranger and took thee in, or naked and clothed thee? Or when saw we thee sick or in prison and came unto thee? And the king shall answer and say unto them, Verily I say unto you, as much as you have done unto me of the least of these, my brethren, you have done it to me. Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, Depart from me, you cursed, into everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungered, and you gave me no meat. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and you took me not in. Naked, and you clothed me not. Sick, and in prison, and you visited me not. Then shall they also answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee and hungered or thirst, and a stranger, or naked, or sick, in prison, and did not minister unto thee? Then shall he answer unto them, saying, Verily I say unto you, as much as you did to one of the least of these, you did it not to me. And these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal. I want to talk to you today about doing to the least of them. You know, as we see these characters come up and we see them walk out here and we look at them and we examine them, and every one of us is guilty of this. Every one of us is guilty of throwing a stone and saying, well, you can't help nobody that won't help themselves. What we need to realize as Christians is without Christ, they can't help themselves. All they know is alcohol. All they know is drugs. All they know is being homeless. All they know is prostitution. We've got to realize there's always a route to anything that leads us away from God. Whether it's something that happened in our life, and I ask you today, if you've got something in your life today that's holding you back from a true relationship with Christ, I ask you that today you would think about that, getting all hindrances out of the way. How can we start 2018 on a better note than saying, I'm going to let my past be gone and my future shine bright before me? How can we do better service for God than we're going to say, Lord, unblind our eyes to the fact of what matters the most? You know, as the play was said here, what mattered the most was the man seeing his Savior come, and he was so focused on preparing the table and not preparing his heart. He didn't prepare his heart. He didn't prepare his heart for the people that God would send him. He didn't prepare his heart for what God was speaking to him. You know, we talk about seed being fallen on stony ground. You know, what we've got to realize is, as a church, we've got to build relationships. And it ain't about four walls. It's not about witness outreach ministries. It's about what Christ can do in your life. No greater joy than you'll ever find than seeing God use you in a ministry. I challenge you this year to get involved. I challenge you, if I say that anything that we're lacking on, it's not salvation, God's going to send us a harvest. I believe that through prayer. I believe God showed me that when we was moving out to this building, that the harvest is going to be plenty. And man, are we seeing that? Are we seeing a harvest? Yes. We're seeing a harvest. I don't know that maybe 1 week we hadn't used the baptistry, and I'm not here about that. Yes, I want to see that. So we're seeing the harvest. The Bible says the harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. We need to pray, God, send us laborers. We need to make laborers of ourselves. Amen? And we need to have a heart for all these problems and all these things that's put before us. We are the hands and feet of Jesus. Amen? We're to do a work for Christ. I love that saying that my sister and them always said, sitting on G, waiting on O. The Bible says in season and out of season. In season and out of season. We come in here, this is season. This is in season. We can come here and we can do the church thing. But there's a thing called out of season. When it don't feel good, when you don't want to do it, but you let the power of God be inside you that'll make you do things that you would have never done. Show love you never show. And have compassion where you never would have had compassion. So I just challenge you this year. I challenge you this week. You know, this is an awesome time. Christmas. We celebrate our Savior's birthday. but let it be about our Savior. Amen.